This tutorial is going to show you how to use the Mogees Audio Unit plugin with Logic Pro 10. I've already got the plugin installed on my computer, so I'm going to open up Logic, and I'm going to add an audio track with the input set to number 1. The first thing that I want to make sure is that Logic has found the Mogees plugin. So under Preferences, there is the Plugin Manager. I can see that Mogees is down here at the bottom of my list. If it's not appearing on yours, you can reset and rescan. The Mogees installer puts the file in the default home library with the following file path. So let's add the Mogees plugin as an audio effect onto this empty track. I'll use the audio unit version. If this is the first time that you've opened the Mogees plugin, you'll have to enter your registration code and add your email and create a password for yourself. However, if you've already registered before, maybe you registered it on the iOS version, you can just log in here. So now I'm just going to enter my email, come up with a password, and enter my registration code. You'll need to be connected to the internet if this is the first time that you're registering your Mogees. Okay, so now I'm going to get my Mogees. I'm going to take off the cap and stick it to this old frying pan. It needs to be attached very firmly so that it should have quite a lot of resistance if I try to take it back off. And remember, if the sticky pad gets dirty and loses its adhesiveness, you can always just peel it off, wash it under some water, wipe away the dirt, and then wait for it to dry before putting it back on. I'm then going to plug it into the 3.5mm to quarter inch adapter, and then I'm going to use a standard guitar cable to run from the adapter into channel 1 of my audio interface. I then want to set the correct pre-gain, so I'll use this microphone level input, and I'm going to start tapping with this pen as loudly as I believe that I will be playing, and increase the gain on my preamp. It's very important that it doesn't go into the red and start clipping. If it is clipping, then the Mogees plugin will be far worse at the gesture recognition. So now within Logic's audio preferences, I want to make sure that I have my correct sound card selected. Your input device may appear different to this one here, but this should be the name of your audio interface. You can see now that if I tap the object to which my Mogees is attached, I've got some input level coming in and it's not clipping, so that's good. If I turn on input monitoring, we should be able to hear the sound of the Mogees plugin. So here is the Mogees plugin. At the moment, there are 4 sound engines. You can just click on them to select them. And each sound engine has a list of presets. And each preset will allow you to change some of its synthesis parameters as well. And using the keyboard, you can click on a note to change the pitch. And you can also change the octave if you wish by clicking on these labels. So let's say I've got a song and I want to play the melody live with my Mogees. We can send MIDI notes to the Mogees plugin so that the pitch of the Mogees is always in sync with my track. To do this, I'm going to create a new external MIDI track, and I'm going to just drag this MIDI clip onto that track, and I'll quickly loop this section. When you have an instance of the Mogees plugin running, there will be virtual MIDI ports open that allow you to send MIDI to the Mogees plugin or send MIDI from the Mogees plugin. If you look at the settings for this MIDI track, we can send MIDI to the Mogees plugin by selecting Mogees 1 as the port. If I now hit play and go back to the plugin, we can see that the notes on the keyboard are moving around, and as I play, the notes will correspond to the notes in this MIDI track. There are a couple of advanced settings that I want to draw attention to now, so let's press on the icon with the 3 lines. If you're using the Muon sound engine, you may want to tweak the audio gate. So if you set this to 0, it will simply let all of the audio come through the physical model of the Muon sound engine. However, if you were to turn it up, you might have to play a little bit louder for the raw audio to come through. When using MIDI input, you might want the pitch to change with very gentle touches. If so, you can reduce the trigger threshold. However, if you only want the pitch to update with very strong hits, you can increase the trigger threshold. We'll talk more about these advanced settings later. So with Mogees, you can assign different types of hits or strikes to play different notes or sounds. First, you need to train the plugin to recognize these different types of taps. We call these scrapes or strikes or scratches or whatever. We call them gestures. So all I've got here is an audio track with the Mogees plugin, and I want my first gesture to be tapping my thumb on the handle, and I want that to trigger a bass note. So I'm going to click on the plus icon, and I'm going to provide it with at least 12 training examples. Now it's very important that only one dot appears each time I tap. If more than one dot is appearing, then I might want to go into my advanced settings and increase the trigger threshold and begin the training process from scratch. However, if no dots are appearing, then I might want to reduce my trigger threshold so that it picks up quieter onsets. The trigger time slider sets the number of onsets or hits that will be detected within a certain number of milliseconds. So if I'm playing on a rattly or a wobbly surface like a cymbal or something that shakes a lot, I may want to increase the trigger time so that it only recognizes my hit and not the object shaking afterward. Okay, so back to my first gesture. I'm going to tap a dozen times, giving it a variety of amplitudes and playing around the area, not exactly always on the same spot. This circle now represents my first gesture. If I select it, I can change the sound engine and the preset and the note if I wish. So now, when I perform my first gesture, it's going to play the mute bass sound with middle C. Now I'm going to train a second gesture. This time I'll use my knuckles in the center of the pan. So again, I'm going to hit plus and give it training examples with a variety of amplitudes and around the area, just as if I were performing. When I'm happy, I'll hit done. So now the plugin can tell the difference between my thumb and the center. I'm just going to click on the blue icon and change that preset to mute bass and select this note. In order to be recognized as distinct, gestures need to be quite different from one another. For example, if I were to train a third gesture of using my thumb on the edge of the pan, you'll see that the circles will end up overlapping. This means that the plugin will have a hard time telling the difference between the two. So I'm going to control click or right click on this yellow gesture to delete it. So instead of using my thumb, I'm going to use this pen and tap the edge of it. So I'll select the Muon sound engine and this note. And now I can play all three independently. So just like we were sending MIDI information in before, we can now send different MIDI tracks to different gestures. I'm only going to use two gestures for this example, so I'm going to right-click on the yellow one to delete it. So I'm going to create two new external MIDI tracks. I'm going to quickly grab these clips and put them up. And I want to send the output of this MIDI track to Mogees number one, channel one, and the output of the second MIDI track to Mogees number one again, but this time I'm going to use channel two. So what this means, if we take a look at the Mogees plugin again, my first gesture is listening for MIDI information on MIDI input channel number one. So since this MIDI track is sending it to MIDI channel number one, these notes are going to stream in real time to this gesture. For my blue gesture, you see that the MIDI input channel is number two. So that's going to listen to this MIDI track. To make this a bit clearer, I'm just going to change the sound preset of my second gesture. I'll record enable the Mogees track again, and I'll hit play. Mogees can also be used as a MIDI controller or trigger by sending MIDI out. So I'm going to create a new software instrument track, and I'm going to load up the Alchemy plugin. The Alchemy plugin is currently listening to all MIDI ports. I'm going to turn down the output of the Mogees track and make sure that it's record enabled. I can see as I play, I'm actually triggering the MIDI notes with my gestures. If you want to route specific Mogees plugins to control specific synths, then you'll want to use Logic's MIDI environment. Now with Logic 10, this is hidden by default, so you may want to go to Logic's Preferences, go to Advanced, and tick on the MIDI option. This means that you can now go to Window and open the MIDI environment. What we'll want to do here is create a new physical input. You see that this is a list of all of my input devices, and Mogees number 1 is available to us. That's because I've got the Mogees plugin loaded up on this audio track. So I'll go back to my MIDI environment. I'm going to select the tiny triangle from the Mogees 1 and plug that into the synthesizer that I want to trigger. This becomes important if you've got more than one Mogees, so I'm going to duplicate this track. And you'll see if I go back to my MIDI environment, there are now two instances of the virtual MIDI ports for Mogees. So this means that I can route them to independent tracks so that they can each control different synthesizers. This is useful if you've got a setup with multiple Mogees plugged into your sound card, or you're working on a track with a few plugins that are triggering different synths. The MIDI velocity slider in advanced settings can be used to set the range of MIDI velocities that are output by the plugin. So that's all for this Logic tutorials. If you've got any questions, please head on over to mogees.co.uk/forum. And thanks for watching.